I'm asking you, the startup accuracy or the company before that? We just started to discuss accuracy.
Okay, so let's start our discussion. It means let's continue our class. Last class we were discussing about the So last class we understand that at what point we are going to use our statistical methods, and we obviously understand we are going to use in the at the end of the step, means the evaluation. So because of the instrumental methods, you guys, those who are online, you are able to hear me?
Yes, sir.
Yes, or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so we started at the different process, and at the end of the process, it was the quantification. After that, evaluation. So quantification, it means performing the necessary quantitative step. If you can relate the concentration of the species with the, if you relate the response with the concentration of the species, that is known as quantification. Because of the instrumental methods, we were able to collect more than 10 results per sample. Okay, so you cannot report all the 10 samples, it will be confusing. You are going to report only one value, that is most of the time mean. Sometimes we use median also. So mean and median, I told you what it is. After that, here comes our statistical methods. So somehow you designed all the steps. Okay, first step, second step, we followed all the steps and you analyzed it. Now the question is, your result is really correct or not? If it is correct, how much correct? If it is not correct, how much it is not correct? That we have to see. For that purpose, you can say this term accuracy. Okay, so already I told you, I think some of the points. Again, in the examination point of view, suppose I am asking accuracy, you have to write all the 4 points. Okay, and it depends on the marks also. Suppose I am asking for one mark question, then you may define only, just define, and you may write the how it can be expressed simply, absolute error and relative error. But if I am asking differentiate accuracy and precision, or compare accuracy and precision, then whatever 4 points given here, in addition, whatever another 4 point I am going to give the precision, you have to write. Okay, comparison of accuracy and precision, or differentiate between accuracy and precision, each I am going to give you at least 4 points. Okay, so first of all, accuracy, it is the measure of how close the experimental value to the true value. And did I tell you about the true value? What is the meaning of true value? Did I tell you? Yeah, so we have to use the, we can use the two terms. One is true value, another one is accepted value. But the more correct term is accepted value, because true value is never known. But still we can have a true value is always something hypothetical, we can say, or something in theory only. Okay, because the true value is never known. All the value what we are getting is coming from a measurement, and that measurement is having error. That's why we are saying that true value is never known. But you can get a value which is very close to the true value, that is called the accepted value. So accepted value and true value, we are going to use synonymously. And you can see there are other terms. I am giving experimental results, and you see calculated value, all those things. So experimental results, or measured value, or calculated value, or experimental value, all these things are going to be used synonymously. It means they are going to have the same meaning. If I say calculated value, that is your result. Okay. If I say experimental value, that is your final result. Okay. So all are going to be synonymously used. There is no difference between these terms. But there is a difference between accepted value and true value. Right. So second point, you can see how you can determine the accuracy. It is the concordance between the accepted value and your calculated value. Okay, and the third point, so that accuracy expresses the correctness of your measurement. Okay, correctness of your measurement. Then we understand, okay, our experimental value is very close to the true value or accepted value, it is fine. but how much it is close or how much it is deviating, to say quantitatively, we are having two terms, that is known as absolute error and relative error. Absolute error, the symbol simply we write E, and relative error, the symbol E subscript R. And relative error is going to be always in terms of percentage, because so this is only difference. The absolute error is only the difference. It can have the sign also, unit also. Unit means milligram. Suppose your results in milligram, it is milligram. Suppose your results in milligram per liter, it is in milligram per liter. Suppose your results are in centimeter, it is centimeter. The same thing, because we are going to take the difference, so it is going to be the same unit of your result, right? And then, so, and you see measured value minus accepted value. Sometimes this value may be high, or sometimes it will be less than the accepted value, so that it will have a sign and also unit. But when you come to the relative error, you can see it is always expressed in terms of percentage, okay? And we usually neglect the sign, but sometimes, very rarely, people use the sign also. Okay, instead of modulus, you take simply the sign and the value also. Sometimes, in some rarely some books they are following, but in the case of relative error, it's not so important to use the use the sign. Okay, so you can take the modulus divided by the accepted value multiplied by 100. Okay, this much accepted value or this much value is having this error. So 100% is how much? So that is called relative error. And we will see about this relative error again at some other point, because this relative error is a much more useful term to compare the compare between the two result. Suppose I am giving you one sample to you, another sample to him, right? But the same substance, right? Magnesium determination, you and you. And the values are different, okay? For example, your conduct is at only 10 milligram, his conduct is 20 milligram, okay? Now, if you take the absolute error, it will be different. It will be different. But if you take the relative error, it may be comparable. Because 20 gram of total content can give more absolute error. But when it comes to relative error, because it is expressed in terms of 100, doesn't bother about the total value, real value, okay? So it is always better to compare the relative error. This point I will tell you in some other place, okay, not now. So accuracy, these are the terms for the accuracy. And when we go to the next one, when we go to the next one, precision. Again, it is exactly, you see, we cannot say it is opposite, but it says something different from the accuracy. Okay, so many of you must be thinking that both accuracy and precision are same, yeah, maybe earlier. Okay, it is accurate, it is precise, my experiments are precise, you say. Sometimes you say some my experiments are accurate, but they are totally different. Okay, accuracy says something about the correctness, and precision says something about the coincidence or concordance between the results. So you can see, it is the measure of reproducibility of analysis. Okay, take a liquidity titration. First, you are doing the titration, you are getting the result. Let us say 5.2 milligram per liter. Sorry, 5.2 gram per liter. Right? Then you are doing another analysis. It may go to 5.5 gram. That is fine. It is more or less close. But if you are getting 7.8, then it is highly deviating. So if you are getting five values, like 5.2 gram per liter, 5.5 gram per liter, 5.8 gram per liter, and 4.9 gram per liter, then you can understand, okay, these are very close to each other. But how much they are close or how much they are deviation, so that we can say quantitatively, that I will tell you later. But because of this, whether this results can be reproduced or not within the acceptable deviation, to understand that, it says about the reproducibility. So if you are getting repeatedly same value or near about same value, you can say that your experiment is reproducible. So therefore we can say it is the measure of reproducibility of analysis. And precision may be defined as the concordance of a series of measurement of the same quantity. You take only one sample, and make 10 results or 5 results, and how these 5 results are close to each other is known as precision. So earlier we compared with the accepted value, okay, your final result, only one result, and you compared that result with the accepted value for accuracy. But here precision, so many results you got and how these results are coinciding each other, okay. And then third point, therefore precision measures the reproducibility of the measurement, okay. And fourth one is precision, it is a measure of reproducibility of analysis, okay. So reproducibility is in nothing but your experiment is going okay or not, so if you are able to measure first time 5.2 gram, next time the same analysis gives very near to that one, say for example 5.1 gram or 5.3 gram, and the next one you are doing again, it is very near to that 5.2 gram, then it says that it is reproducible. Your 10 results are very much close to each other, it means it is reproducible. That's why suppose you are making 5 measurements and these 5 measurements are close to each other, 5.1, 5.2, 5.3, 5.2, close to each other, then you can say that your experiment is reproducible. Okay, we are going to say the precision is says about how close these values are to each other. That's why we say precision represents the reproducibility of the analysis. Reproducibility is nothing but if you are doing the experiment for a particular sample here, it should show the same value, and next day same sample in some other place, some other laboratory, maybe foreign also, if you are getting the same value, that it is reproducible. It depends on the method and also the hand, means the person who is performing the experiment. So we will see that things also. So precision can be expressed in terms of the following, okay. Where is the cursor? Yes, precision is expressed using the following terms. So for the accuracy, I told you absolute error and relative error, okay. So we understand accuracy says the correctness of the measurement, but how much correct, to understand that we are using quantitative term, error and absolute error. Similarly here you are saying that your values are close to each other and the experiment is reproducible, but how much reproducible, how much deviation is there? To say quantitatively, you can use the following terms. What are the terms? There are so many terms, you can you may be knowing it. The very first one is the average deviation. So now you can understand why I gave you some kind of complicated thing for the calculation of mean. I put sigma xi divided by n, even though everyone knows, just I put sigma xi by n. Now you can understand why I gave you, you see, xi minus x bar. What is xi minus x bar? That is simply, so this I should be subscript. This I should be subscript. Each time I changing it, but sometimes it is because of equation, it's not coming. So xi, we know it, individual measurements, right? And x bar, we know it, average, mean, okay? So xi minus x bar is the deviation. So xi means individual measurement. You are having 5 measurement or 10 measurement. Minus x bar is the average of all the measurements. I will give you one example, then you can understand more clearly. Xi minus x bar is the deviation of each individual measurement. Now you are summarizing the each individual measurement, that is summation sigma, and each deviation you summarize and then divide it by the number of experiment, that will give you the average deviation. But this is not a very good term for the comparison purpose. I will tell you after some time, okay. So this is the very first and easy term to calculate the precision, okay. Now the second one is standard deviation. What? But they should ask, they are using something, they are spying. What do you say? Come.
Come.
Okay, so yes, so what you say in Hindi, suppose you are hearing somebody unknowingly, what do you say in Hindi? Like this guy was hearing me without knowing me, he is standing outside and hearing, what is that? What you say in Hindi? Okay, we will ask later. Okay, so the very common term for the accuracy is the, sorry, precision is the standard deviation. All of you know very well, yes? At least you must be hearing this word, standard deviation, yes? So you can calculate standard deviation like this, sigma xi minus x bar whole squared, everything under the root, n minus 1, okay? The whole thing is under the root, right? So here we are using n minus 1 for some reason. It is supposed to be n. You see, here we are using n only, okay? But here we are using n minus 1. So it is supposed to be n only, but statistical reason we are using n minus 1. Simply I can tell you, maybe not the exact reason, but simply I can tell you that why we are using n minus 1 is that at least one individual observation having no deviation. Okay, we are assuming in the calculation at least one measurement is having no deviation. So that's why n minus 1. Okay, so if you really want to understand more, you should read the statistics. Okay. So anyhow, our point is to understand how we are going to calculate the standard deviation and how it is going to be applied in our analysis. Okay, so standard deviation, very normal term or very frequently used term in the precision. And the next one is relative standard deviation, okay, RSD. So relative standard deviation, normally we say RSD, without a full stop between, or with full stop, not a problem, okay. R dot, S dot, D, you can write, not a problem, or simply you can write RSD, okay. And most of the time, or almost always, this RSD is expressed in terms of percentage only, and it is S. Something is not clear, but S divided by X bar multiplied by 100. Okay, so S is nothing but the standard deviation, X bar is nothing but the X bar is the average. Okay, and then 100 is for to calculate into percentage. And there is one more term, coefficient of variation. This is also same calculation, it is nothing but exactly you are replacing the term with the coefficient of variation. So CV, coefficient of variation, and relative standard deviation, RSD, are same. Okay, that's why I put these two together, and most of the time these two are expressed in terms of percentage. Not most of the time, always we can say. If you say relative standard deviation, it is expressed in terms of percentage only. Okay, and you can calculate this one. But CV, when you say CV, it is not always expressed in terms of percentage. It is expressed sometimes in terms of PPT, parts per thousand, not something like parts per trillion, not like that, okay? PPT, parts per thousand. Simply you multiply, instead of 100, you multiply by 1000. So here we use the 100 to calculate the percentage. Here we are using 1000 to calculate the PPT, okay? So CV and RSD, it can be expressed in terms of percentage, but CV sometimes can be expressed in terms of PPT also, right? So these are all are the precision parameter. In the earlier case, accuracy parameter, we just discussed only two, absolute error, relative error. In this case, still we are having so many. Okay, the next way is probably, standard error of the mean. Okay, standard error of the mean or standard deviation of the mean. Okay, that is another term. The symbol is S subscript mean. So this is your standard deviation, right? Divided by root of n. It is known as standard error of the mean or standard deviation of the mean. This is another term. And one more term. Relative standard error of the mean or relative standard deviation of the mean, that is normally written like this. S subscript mean, subscript relative, and whenever it comes to relative, always remember it is a 2%. Relative error expressed in terms of percentage. Relative standard deviation, percentage. And here, relative standard error of the mean or relative standard deviation of the mean is expressed in terms of percentage. Okay, S mean. So from here, S mean divided by X bar multiplied by 100. Okay, and now, yes, now come here. What about the unit? This average deviation will have unit or will not? Tell me quickly. It will have unit, and the unit will be the same of your results. Suppose your results are in milligram, this average deviation also will be in milligram. And what about the standard deviation? So it will have sign or not? Average deviation will have sign also. Okay.
Yes.
Average deviation can have sign and must have unit, right? So, and standard deviation. You are having some question? So, what about the unit of the standard deviation?
Same as that of average deviation.
Okay, if your results are in milligram, this is, so it is nothing but how much your results are deviating from the average, okay? But what about the sign?
Always positive, sir. Always positive.
It is plus or minus because we are taking a root, na? So we should say plus or minus. It could be plus or minus, huh? Right. So, and relative standard deviation. Usually, you see standard deviation we have taken, it is a plus or minus. But most of the time, we don't consider the minus sign, but we take the positive sign only. But if you are writing minus sign, that is also fine. But since it is derived from the standard deviation, which can have a positive value also, negative value also, it can be in terms of percentage, it can be minus also. But most of the time, we omit the minus sign and we write it only in positive sign. So it will have the positive sign most of the time, and it is not having the unit. Percentage it is. Percentage is not a unit, okay? Because you can see standard deviation is same, let us say milligram, average is also in milligram, so you are dividing it, so no unit. And come here, this also has no unit, but you can say parts per thousand. It is neither percentage or no unit, but it is PPT. A kind of, we cannot say it is a unit, it's simply parts per thousand, like percentage, parts per thousand. Okay, so again, S mean will have the unit and plus or minus sign because we are using plus. Sorry, S is a plus or minus sign. And here, most of the time, we omit the sign and it is expressed in terms of percentage. It means no unit, but in terms of percentage. And there is one more term, variance, S squared. So don't have confused with the variance and coefficient of variation. These two are entirely different one. So coefficient of variation is a different formula, but variance is another different formula, right? There are some more terms like range and spread are also precision parameter. Range means, suppose you see your results are lowest value is, let us say 5.1 milligram and the highest value is 6.1 milligram, then you can say our results are in this range, 5.1 to 6.1. So it is not a very, very quantitative term. So that's why I didn't say anything. But range is also a precision parameter. And spread. Spread means, again, the difference between the lowest value and the highest value. Okay. So your deviation is spreading or precision is spread in this range. So that is also not so very much quantitative. So I omitted this one. But you should know range and spread are also precision parameter. Now, you see, these are your homework.
Sir,
note them.
Sir. Sir.
Someone is talking to me?
Yes, sir.
Tell me.
Sir, how the standard deviation value will be negative also, sir? As it is having the square, so negative value to positive ho jayega na?
No. Standard deviation is equal to under the root of something. Always root plus 3 also 9, minus 3 also 9. So whenever you take a root, it should be said to be plus or minus the value. Okay. Plus or minus. Understand? Hello.
Yes, sir.
Okay. You understand, na? Standard deviation. Okay, I am showing you. You see, the standard deviation S is square root of something. Okay. If you take a square of something, it will always either plus value. Suppose the S is, let us say, this whole term is 3. Okay. Then you will get S is equal to root of 3. Or if it is 9, you will get 3. It is, so root of 9, it could be plus 3 also, minus 3 also. It is very simple thing. I cannot explain more than that really, actually. You follow?
Yes, sir.
Root of minus number also, root of plus number also going to give the same value. Root of minus 9 and root of minus, sorry, root of minus 9 and root of 9, that's are going to be 3 only. That's why we write always the standard deviation is equal to plus or minus some value. Follow?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So let's go further. You note down this three things. Actually, I am having some problem in this mic. So this mic, I am not receiving, you can see. So at least next time I will bring them some headphone. So it will be okay. So tell me, sir, not tell me. You may note down all these three things and do it as a homework. Okay. And you are supposed to submit assignment, okay? You know it. You know, na? Assignment. Out of 30 marks, no, not usually normal days when there is no this lockdown and all. It is not audible? So next week I will put some microphone and headphone, but you can hear right now here, man. You can hear right now to me directly. Fine. You are not understanding. See, why you are checking by the mic, or why you are attending by online right now? You can directly talk to me. Right now, that is the everyone is offline. You can talk to me. My voice is reaching you now. Right now, I'm not talking about online. Right now, your voice is reaching. So you are offline. You talk to me offline. So when you are, it is better when you are here. You can. It is not necessary to connect it. Okay. And when you are outside, it is necessary to connect. Anyhow, note down these things. You know assignment, yes? So for 30 marks, not 30 marks, whenever there is no lockdown or something, you are supposed to have a mid-semester exam. I think from the beginning, you never give the mid-semester. Or in the first semester, you give. Yes. So there will be mid-semester exam for 20 marks. And the remaining 10 marks will be about to evaluate it from the assignment. Okay. And suppose this portion means analytical chemistry, if suppose we are teaching three teachers, maybe all three teachers give you assignment, or maybe only one teacher may give you assignment, or maybe two teachers, like that. Okay. So we used to give assignment either one or two or three, and collect all the assignment and then evaluate it for out of 10 marks, right? But now what happens, no class test, no mid-semester, okay? So that's why the same 10 mark is being evaluated for 30 marks. Okay, each three of us will collect your assignment and we evaluated for 10 each, and then for totally 30. So we don't know whether you are going to have a class test for 20 mark or you will not have. Okay, so that's why we don't know, but all these questions, whenever I give you, you try to complete it and keep it with you. Okay, don't throw the paper anywhere. You complete it and keep it with you. And I will tell you one day, then at the time, you should submit all the numerical problems to me as an assignment. Okay. So today I have given three. Maybe after 2 days, next week I will give you another one. Like that, until my portions are going to complete, I will be going on giving you some numerical examples. You should complete it and submit as an assignment at the end. That last date I will tell you later. So this is your homework. And especially when you are completing this, you will understand all the problems. Maybe I can show, probably I worked something. Acha, maybe let me see.
Excuse me, sir.
See, something we already worked out. I will tell you, so at the time also you can understand, but let me go further.
Excuse me, sir.
So this is about the accuracy and precision, right? Now, going further, we have...
Excuse me, sir. Time. Sir?
Yeah, it is. Yes, tell me.
Sir, I wanted to ask that, is this that assignment for which we have to submit for having the attendance? Because at the last, we have to also submit an assignment to have the attendance.
No, it is not.
So we have to collect all these questions and give at the last when you will ask for the assignment, no?
I will give you your last date also. And okay, at the time you should submit.
Okay, sir.
So continuing further. Now, about the accuracy and precision, we should understand some two more points. Okay. About the accuracy and precision, two more points we should understand. What are the two more points? First point is this one. All precise measurement may not lead to accurate values, but the reverse is true. What is reverse? However, all accurate results, see, suppose you are getting accurate results, you must have precise measurements. Okay, but that is not reverse. The reverse is not true. Suppose you are having precise measurements, your values are close to each other, it doesn't mean that you are going to have accurate results. Okay, you follow the statement, all precise measurement may not lead to accurate values. Okay, but all accurate values are obtained from precise measurements. Okay, so how it is? I can show this one by two ways. One is a simple Gunshot diagram or aim diagram, you can say. It is understandable to everyone. And another one is with a numerical example. Okay, so first of all, it is simple and anyone can understand. Let us see. So what it is, let me tell you. So assume that you are having a target, Gunshot experiment. Yeah, this year also, this time also, Olympic got some medal for gun shooting. Yes, who? I don't remember, but some 2-3 times before, maybe not last Olympic, before that, Abhinav Bindra, yeah, got gold medal. Yes, we were celebrating every other time. So let us assume that a target, you are allowed to give 10 shots at the game. So you are supposed to point at the center, then only you will get a good score. Yes, these things you know, nah? So your aim should touch at the center, then you will get the full score. Right, so first person is scoring like this. So this is the target and he is allowed to shoot 5 times. Okay, and he is shooting like this. Okay, suppose you are supposed to shoot it here, right? You are getting like this. Okay, and then next person, he is shooting like this. Okay, only one shot is here, but the remaining shots also nearby, right? And you see this guy is shooting here, okay, very close. And then the last one, maybe Avinash Bindra, yeah, so he is shooting like this. Okay, so now you see, this is what very simply I can explain. It is precise. These shots are very close to each other, but somewhere else. So we can say that this particular guy is having some eye problem, we can say. Otherwise his instrument is wrong. So wherever he is aiming, it is going there. So some reason could be there. So some reason could be there. But you see, here it is precise and accurate also. Here it is neither accurate nor precise. So I am writing here, it is neither accurate nor precise. Okay. nowhere it is on the center. But here we can say moderate, accurate, but not precise, definitely. Since I told you moderate, accurate, because it is more or less near, and then one is at the center. So moderate accuracy, but not precise. And then the third one is highly precise, okay? Highly precise, but not accurate. And then this is accurate and precise. So we understand all precise measurement may not lead to the accurate values, but all accurate results, okay, if you are getting accurate results, are obtained from the precise measurement. Yeah, tell me. Okay, so this is based on the simple our general example. Now let us go to the example by the numerical example. Okay, so you just read it, the true value. True value or accepted value. Remember, true value and accepted value, we are going to use synonymously, but the more correct term is the accepted value. So the accepted value of a substance, okay, compound A, is 49.10. Is 49.10, right? Now, the results obtained by two different analytes using the same substance and same method are this one. Okay, first analyst and second analyst, they are getting these values. Okay, so you can see immediately after seeing these two results, definitely you can say that who is accurate and who is precise. Yeah, yeah. Second
so
one
the
is
first
what?
Huh? So the first analyst is more, the second analyst is more precise, and first analyst is more
second
accurate.
Second one is analyst two is very precise, okay, but analyst one is accurate, but not so precise as this guy. Okay, so here you can see what is the average deviation of this result. If you understand the average deviation more clearly, you can tell the answer immediately. You don't need to put the sigma and all. You see and tell me what is the average deviation of the second result. You can see what the formula also. Each you should take the average and deviation of each number, then sum up. Tell me quickly, what is the average deviation of the second analyst? That is average. Second analyst. Average deviation, summation of xi minus x bar divided by n. It will be zero. We can show it will be zero. Okay, that's why this cannot be taken as a one of the precision parameter. Okay, sometimes it may lead to give you a zero value, but let it be. That is the final one, we will discuss it. But here immediately after seeing it, you have told me that this is more precise and this is more accurate. That is correct. But on what basis you have told me on what basis it is precise? Tell me.
Sir, because the difference between the values,
so
the analyst got is very less in the second case.
Yeah, what? Tell me again.
Sir, the differences between the values which the analyst 2 has got is very small, like 49.40.
What is the term? Okay, I tell you. So, quantitatively, when you say, you see, accuracy, I already told you, we should express in terms of absolute error and the relative error. And the precision should be expressed either of this one, standard error, standard deviation, or relative standard deviation, all those things, right? So you should calculate one accuracy parameter and one precision parameter for these two values, and you have to see. So accuracy parameter, let us say in the first case, take absolute error, okay? Absolute error of this one is this much, and absolute error of this one is this much. That's why it is more accurate. So we are going to calculate this one accuracy parameter and one precision parameter. So earlier example also, you can follow this one. This is what I am writing, xi, individual measurements. It is already in terms of percentage, okay? the results accepted value itself in terms of percentage, and whatever the result you are writing, that is also in terms of percentage, remember. Okay, so xi values are this one for the first measurement. This is the method to make no error. Okay, see, usually in the examination you will not be provided if it is offline. Okay, means physical examination, you will not be provided with the calculator, and you should calculate the standard deviation and all. Then this is the best way to do it without making any mistakes. Okay, suppose you can do without making this table, but you may have errors, you may get mistakes. That's why first of all, write all xi values. So xi means individual measurements. These are the individual measurements you write first of all, and take the average. So summation of this one is 196.48, follow, and then divided by n. Here summation of this divided by n is the number of experiment 4, and you got this value 49.12. then this xi is, sorry, x bar is 49.12, and then so xi minus x bar values are the deviation. Yes, so each time you get the deviation minus plus 13 minus point, so something value you got it, and you make the square, because this summation of this square will be used in the standard deviation. Okay, so now you got this value, that is summation of xi minus x bar whole squared is this one. It is going to be used in the standard deviation. Summation of xi minus x bar whole squared divided by n minus 1, that is number of experiments minus 1. Okay, from the formula. So one of the accuracy parameter is E, that is absolute error you calculated. So what is your result? Your final result is your average only. That is your final result. Even though you got 4 readings, so you should report only one value, that is the average. So average is your value, and average you have taken, that is your value, measured value. Okay, minus this 49.1 is the here true value or accepted value. So this gives you 0.02%. Okay, 0.0% absolute error, and when it comes to relative error, 0.04%, because you can see absolute error divided by accepted value multiplied by 100. Fine. Now that is the accuracy parameter, and this is the precision parameter, standard deviation. So based on the formula, that is sigma xi minus x bar whole square. So you got this value here. These are the this one, and you summed up here, and this one divided by n minus 1 under the root. So it is 0.10%. So I removed plus or minus, so don't worry. And RSD is S, okay, 0.1 divided by, what is that, x bar is 49.1, we got it from here, and then multiplied by 100, that is 0.2%. We calculated two accuracy parameter and two precision parameter. Now the same thing should be done for the another one also. So when you are doing, okay, so you can see, yes, so these are the xi values, right, and the summation of these values. So you put here and you got average 49.42. okay, so this also you don't need to sum up and average it if you know it correctly. You see here the deviation is 0.02, okay, and here also the same, 0.04. so average automatically it will come 49.42. okay, by simple visual inspection you can understand. Anyhow, you are calculating the error, absolute error. So average value is your value, that is experimental value, minus the accepted value. It is going to give 0.32%, that is more than this one. So error should be less for more accurate results. If the error is less, it is more accurate. Yeah, so error is less here, so it is more accurate. So only after calculating any this quantitative parameter you can say whether this experiment is accurate or not, right? And this one is The next one is relative error, that is also less, sorry, that is also more here and less here. So, but when you come to the standard deviation, you can see the standard deviation is very, very less here, 0.016. Here it is 0.10 only. Okay, it is more, but here it is less. So standard deviation and relative standard deviation is less for the second measurement. That's why we say it is more precise. And relative error and absolute error are less for the first experiment. That's why we say it is accurate. Okay, now you understand. After that, one more thing you understand, you calculate. So right now, those who are online also, those who are here also, calculate the average deviation of this set of result. Do you can tell me? Calculate the average deviation of this value, this second set of result. So you guys understand? Calculate the average deviation of this set of measurements and tell me the value quickly. Huh? Second one, average deviation of the analyst 2. Zero. Yeah, very good. Understand now? So it is nothing but, you see, summation of xi minus x bar. So in one case minus 0.02, another case it is plus 0.02, but in the remaining two cases it is zero. So it is going to be zero. So now tell me, we are saying that zero deviation. Is it correct? It is not correct. So that's why that average, the average deviation should not be used as a comparison purpose. So it can tell you zero deviation. It means we cannot understand anything further. Yeah. So if you say zero deviation, how you can compare with any other results? So average deviation is not a very good term to compare the result. So we can say it is a first approximation or something, but not for the comparison purpose. And which one is much better? Much better are always relative values. See, this relative value ER and relative standard deviations are better values to compare the results. Okay, so suppose no, that's what I'm saying. It is not correct, actually. You see, if your precision is zero, if you are saying precision parameter average deviation is zero, it says that you are perfectly correct. There is no deviation at all. But it is not true. It is not true. We are calculating the standard deviation. We understand there is a deviation. So that's why I am saying average deviation should not be used. Okay. So so the better way to compare either accuracy or precision is that always relative value. So relative error is better to compare your accuracy, and relative standard deviation is better to compare your precision between the two results. Suppose one guy got result and this guy got another result. If you are comparing, then better to use relative standard deviation and relative error. Okay, so this is the point. And if we have time, we can go further. If we are having, what is the time? Okay, I am stopping at this point. Okay, so those who are here can write in a piece of paper and give to me, and those who are online, they can So absolute error I already asked, yeah. So within 5 minutes or within 10 minutes, this question should be answered and should be sent to my email ID, that is velganesh@yahoo.com. Understand, everyone?
Oi.
So I think we can leave now. Those who are online may ask me something if you have question. since there is no questions, I am ending the meeting, and we can meet in the next week 8 to 9 again. Okay
sir, I have a question. Bye. Sir.